Train invested a certain sum in Scheme A, which offers simple interest at the rate of 8% per annum for 4 years. So here itself, you must know that 8% per annum for 4 years is what? 32% of simple interest. Are you getting it? I mean, while reading the question itself, you know that, okay, this is like, simple interest is going to be 32%. Right? We have discussed all these techniques in the video of simple and compound interest, right? Simple interest of 8% per annum, per year 8%. So in 4 years, you get 32%. How much has he invested is not known to us. Next, he says he also invested Rs 2000 in Scheme B, which offers compound interest. The earlier one was simple interest. Now he's talking about compound interest, compounded annually at 20% per annum for 2 years. Now again, if you had practiced enough, you would know that 20% per annum for 2 years in case of compound interest, which is compounded annually, will give you a compound interest of 44%. Don't ask me how, why all this have been through the video, right? You know that in case of compound interest, we'll add, we'll use effective percentage formula. So 20% for 2 years means what? A plus B plus AB by 100. So 20 plus 20 plus 20 to 20 by 100. And then you should not be doing this calculation on paper again. Simple calculation, right? 20 plus 20 is 40. And this is 4. 40 plus 4 is 44. So you know that the overall compound interest in the scenario will be 44%. So see, by the time you finish reading this part of the question, you know that simple interest is 32%. Compound interest is maybe 44%. Now, if the interest earned from Scheme A is 7 by 11, of the interest earned from Scheme B, which means 32% of the principal that was invested here is 7 by 11 of the interest that has been earned here. What is the sum invested in Scheme A? So the whole question is about sum invested in Scheme A. Let us assume it is PA. Now what is the question? Look at this. This is the statement. If the interest earned from Scheme A, how much is earned from Scheme A? 32% of what? The principal that is invested. So 32% of PA is equal to is. So that replaces equal to 7 by 11, 7 by 11 of the interest earned from Scheme B. Now what is the interest earned from Scheme B? 44%. 44% of what? The amount invested, which is 2000 rupees. See, this amount is given to us. Principal in case of compound interest is given to us. So this is 44% of 2000. That's it. One single step. Simplify. Cut down the number of steps. Basically, that's the idea, right? Cut down the number of steps. So you know that percentages get cancelled on both the sides, because like by 100 and by 100. This goes how many times? 4 times. 7 fours is 28. This goes 8 times. So the principal here will be how much? 2000 by 8 into 7. How much is 2000 by 8? 250. 250 into 7? 1750. Yes, sir? 250 into 6 is 1500. Into 7 will be 1500 plus 250, which is 1750. So answer should be option 5. Now this.